गुड आफ्टरनून, मैसेल डॉक्टर पल्लवी चौधरी. टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ प्रैक्टिकल इज लीजन्स ऑफ कार्डियोवास्कुलर सिस्टम एंड द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस प्रैक्टिकल. एट द एंड ऑफ सेशन यू शुड एबल टू डिफाइन द आर्टेरियोस्क्लेरोसिस एंड डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन द टाइप ऑफ आर्टेरियोस्क्लेरोसिस एंड एबल टू डिस्कस द एपिडेमियोलॉजी एंड रोल ऑफ रिस्क फैक्टर इन द पैथोजेनेसिस ऑफ आर्टेरियोस्क्लेरोसिस एंड डिस्क्राइब द पैथोजेनेसिस ऑफ आर्टेरियोस्क्लेरोसिस and the morphology and microscopy of atherosclerotic plaques and the complicated plaques and they describe the epidemiology and risk factor of ischemic heart disease and describe the pathogenesis and dynamic plaque changes in ischemic heart disease and then clinical presentation of ischemic heart disease and the pathogenesis and response of myocardial ischemia and gross and microscopy of myocardial infarction and discuss the lab diagnosis and complication of acute coronary syndrome. Before going to the various lesion of heart, just see the picture of normal vascular wall. The innermost layer is intima, is composed of endothelial cells, and then it is an internal elastic lumen, and then media, there is a middle layer, and then external elastic lamina, and then adventitia. This is the normal layer of vascular wall. Now, what is the arteriosclerosis? Arteriosclerosis is hardening of arteries and thickening and loss of elasticity of arterial wall. And there is a three patterns of arteriosclerosis. First one is atherosclerosis, then Mogber's medial calcific sclerosis and arteriosclerosis. This is the picture of Mogber arteriosclerosis. It's a calcific deposit and muscular artery in the person older than the age of 50. It can be radiographically visible and often palpable and calcification. And it do not encroach on the vessel lumen. That's why it is clinically non-significant. And then atherosclerosis. It is characterized by intimal lesion called atheromas or atheromatous or fibroflattic plaque. It obstruct the vascular lumens and weaken the underlying media. Now, what are the risk factor of atherosclerosis? First one is age. It is older the age, more the risk of atherosclerosis, and male is more prone to atherosclerosis. And any family history, smoking, blood, high cholesterol level, hypertension, sedentary lifestyle, stress, in which there is a type A personality, diabetes mellitus, postmenopausal woman and women taking oral contraceptive pills, with obesity, physical inactivity and alcohol, etc. See, this is a picture of pathogenesis of atherosclerosis. Initially, there is any injury to the vessel wall, and then formation of fatty streak, and then fibrous plaque formation, which composed of smooth muscles, RBCs, foam cells, cholesterol cleft, and then formation of thrombus with the aggregation of platelet. Now the natural history of atherosclerosis by the American Heart Association classification of human atherosclerotic lesion, nomenclature and mainly histology. In type 1 lesion, there is isolated macrophage form cell form aggregation. In type 2, fatty streak lesion, mainly intracellular lipid accumulation. In type 3, there is intermediate lesion, in which there is a type 2 changes plus small extracellular lipid pool. And type 4, atheroma lesion, in which there is a type 2 changes and core of extracellular lipids. And type 5 lesion, and there is a lipid core and fibrotic layer or multiple lipid cores and fibrotic layer, or mainly calcific or mainly fibrotic. And type 6, that is complicated lesion, in which there is a surface defect, hematoma or hemorrhage, and thrombus formation. The gross view of atherosclerosis in the aorta. Picture A showing the mild atherosclerosis composed of fibrous plaque shown by the arrow, and the severe disease with diffuse and complicated lesion. This is a cut section of vessel. See, the classical is in the occlusion of lumen by the atherosclerotic plaque. The cut section of artery showing the tear in the atrial wall. Macrophages, cholesterol deposition, red blood cells, macrophage form cells and fat deposit. See, there is cut section of first one is normal artery, second one is a mild atherosclerosis, there is a mild lumen occlusion. In severe atherosclerosis, there is a more than 90% lumen occlusion by the atherosclerotic plaque. Morphologically, the key process in the atherosclerosis are intimal thickening and the lipid accumulation. An atheroma or atheromatous plaque consists of raised focal lesion initiating within the intima, having a soft yellow groomish core of lipid mainly composed of cholesterol and cholesterol ester and covered by firm white fibrous cap. Now, what are the principal components of atherosclerotic plaques? The cells, including the smooth muscle cells, macrophages, other leukocytes, and extracellular matrix including the collagen, elastic fibers, and proteoglycans. And third is intracellular and extracellular lipids. These components occur in varying proportions and configuration in different lesions. See the picture, there is a fibrous cap, composed of smooth muscles, macrophages, cholesterol crystals, form cells. There is a fibrous cap and lumen occlusion seen. So collagen has been stained blue with the mesenterichum stain. The hypoid view of junction of fibrous cap and core showing the scattered inflammatory cells and calcification and neovascularization. This shown by the arrow. The arteriosclerosis. There's so two type of arteriosclerosis. One is hyaline arteriosclerosis and hypoplastic arteriosclerosis. In figure A is picture of hyaline arteriosclerosis in which there is a arterial wall is hyalinized and the lumen is markedly narrowed. And B picture is hypoplastic arteriosclerosis. It is onion skinning causing lumen obliteration. Onion skinning is due to the hypoplasia of smooth muscle cells of vessel wall. Now the lesion of heart. Before going to the various lesion, let's see the normal weight of heart and thickness of the wall. In female, normal weight of heart is 250 to 300 grams and in male 300 to 350 grams. The right wall ventricle thickness is 0.3 to 0.5 centimeter and left ventricular wall thickness is 1.3 to 1.5 centimeter. Greater the heart weight or ventricle thickness indicate the hypertrophy and enlarged chamber size implies the dilatation. The increased cardiac weight or size is termed as a cardiomegaly. And the blood supply of heart, there is a three major epicardial coronary artery. First one is left anterior descending artery and then left circumference arteries and right coronary arteries. Most coronary arterial blood flow to the myocardium occur during the ventricular diastole, and when the microcirculation is not compressed by the cardiac contraction. See the picture of heart. This picture showing the blood supply of the heart. There is a left coronary artery divided into two branches, the circumference artery and left anterior descending artery. Left coronary artery, circumference artery supply the left atrium and side and back of the left ventricle, and the LAD supply the blood to the front and bottom of the left ventricle and the front of the septum. And the right coronary artery supply blood to the right atrium, right ventricle and bottom portion of the left ventricle and back to the back of the septum. Of the ischemic heart disease. What is the ischemic heart disease? Ischemic heart disease occur when there is insufficient blood flow to a part and area of heart muscle due to blockage in the blood vessel. Ischemic heart disease clinical manifestation of IHD can be divided into four syndrome. First is myocardial infarction, the most important form of ischemic heart disease in which the duration and severity of ischemia is sufficient to cause death of heart muscles, and angina pectoris in which the ischemia is less severe and does not cause death of cardiac muscles. and the chronic ischemic heart disease with heart failure and sudden cardiac death. The acute myocardial infarction, unstable angina and sudden cardiac death are sometimes referred to as acute coronary syndrome. Now, angina pectoris, it characterized by paroxysmal substernal pain. The duration and severity of ischemia are not sufficient to cause infarction, and chest discomfort caused by the transient myocardial ischemia. There is a three overlapping pattern of angina pectoris. First is stable or typical angina, in which there is a angina symptom occur with the same level of exertion and go away with rest, and typically seen when the 75% or greater chronic stable stenosis in coronary artery. Then, transmental or variant angina. It is episodic angina that occur at rest and is due to coronary artery spasm. And third is unstable or crescendo angina. There is a disruption of atherosclerotic plaque with superimposed partial or thrombosis and possibly embolization or vasospasm, or sometimes for the both. The cause of death in heart failure, this is the hypertension, pressure overload volume and valvular disease or pressure or volume, and myocardial infarction. All three cause the increased cardiac work, hypertrophy and dilatation, and this lead to heart failure. Coronary arteries, which cause acute plaque changes and then myocardial infarction and then hypertrophy, dilatation and chronic cardiac failure and sudden death. Now, the risk factor developing the ischemic heart disease. First one is unhealthy blood cholesterol level. A high LDL cholesterol, which is the bad cholesterol, and low HDL cholesterol, which is a good cholesterol. And then high blood pressure, smoking can damage and tighten the blood vessel, cause unhealthy cholesterol level and increase the blood pressure. And diabetes mellitus, high blood sugar level can cause increased fatty deposit on the inside the arterial wall. Then obesity, lack of physical activity, unhealthy diet that is high in saturated fats, cholesterol, salt and sugar can worsen the other risk factor. And age, in women the risk of ischemic heart disease increase from 45 years of age. In women, the risk of ischemic heart disease increase from the age of 55. And then family history. Now the myocardial infarction. Heart attack is the death of cardiac muscle due to prolonged severe ischemia. And the pathogenesis of myocardial infarction are coronary artery occlusion at any level, formation of microthrombi, vasospasm and formation of emboli. The ischemia without atherosclerosis and thrombosis are vasculitis, sickle cell disease, myeloid deposition of heart. This is just showing the progression of myocardial ischemia. See the occlusion at the and left anterior descending artery. Firstly, there is a affect the endocardium and then increase the zone of necrosis and affect the all three full thickness of the wall. Now the sequential pathological changes in the myocardial infarction. At up to 6 hours, there is a no change on gross examination and no changes in light microscopy, but sometimes there is a stretching and waviness of fiber can be seen. In up to 6 to 12 hours, there is a coagulative necrosis, neutrophilic infiltration begins, and edema and hemorrhage can be seen on light microscopy examination. In 24 hours, there is a cyanotic red purple area of hemorrhage seen on cross examination, and then coagulation necrosis progressive and marginal neutrophilic infiltration seen on microscopic examination. And 48 to 72 hours, there is a yellow tan infarct center seen on gross examination, and then coagulative necrosis complete, neutrophilic infiltration well developed, and after 3 to 7 days, there is a hyperemic border center yellow and soft area seen on gross examination, and neutrophil necrosed disappearing, beginning of resorption of necrosis fiber by macrophage and onset of fibrovascular response. On 10th day, there is a red purple periphery on gross examination and necrosis muscle in small infarct removed. Fibrovascular reaction is markedly seen, pigmented macrophages present, eosinophil lymphocytes, plasma cells are seen. On 14th day, there is a necrosed muscle mostly removed, neutrophilic disappear, fibrocollagenous tissue at the periphery. On the third week, there is necrosed muscle fiber form a larger infarct removed and more ingrowth of fibrocollagenous tissue. And 4th to 10th week, there is a thin grayish white hard shrunken fibrous scar seen on gross examination and increased fibrogenic tissue, decreased vascularity, few pigmented macrophages and lymphocytes and plasma cells are seen. See, this is a cut section of heart showing the myocardial infarction scar, healing scar, the whitish. This, all these whitish area are healing scar of myocardial infarction on left ventricular wall. There is a picture of acute myocardial infarction demonstrated histochemically by a lack of staining by triphenyl tetrazolium chloride, and staining defect is due to enzyme leakage that follow the cell death. This arrow showing the pale area, this is the area of necrosis which is not stained by triphenyl tetrazolium chloride. On the one day, old infarct showing the coagulating necrosis along with the wavy fiber, elongated and narrow. Compared with the adjacent normal, at the right side there is a normal fiber, widened space between the dead fiber and contain edema fluid and scattered neutrophil. There is a dense polymorphonuclear cell infiltration in the area of acute infarction of 3 to 4 days of duration. Complete removal of necrotic myocytes by the phagocytosis at the approximately 7 to 10 days. This is the picture of well healed myocardial infarct with replacement of necrotic fiber by dense collagenous scar, and few very residual cardiac muscle are seen. Now the consequences and complication of myocardial infarction. First one is contractile dysfunction, arrhythmia, myocardial rupture, pericarditis, right ventricular infarction, infarct extension, neural thrombus, ventricular aneurysm, papillary muscle dysfunction, and progressive late heart failure. With the clinical presentation of myocardial infarction, there is a rapid weak pulse, substernal chest pain, nausea, sweating, vomiting, dyspnea due to pulmonary congestion, edema, and sometimes can be present as a asymptomatic, in which there is a ECG change seen and new Q wave is seen on ECG. Investigation in myocardial infarction, we can do enzymes assay like creatine kinase, troponin and CKMB have high sensitivity and specificity. Total CK and CKMB activity disappear after 72 hours. Can ECG, radioisotope study, perfusion, scintigraphy and MRI. That goes to the rheumatic heart disease. Rheumatic heart disease is associated with the rheumatic fever, which seriously affect the heart and joint and may involve the nervous system and respiratory system. Rheumatic heart fever is acute immunologically mediated and multi-system inflammatory disease. It can follow an episodes of group A streptococcal pharyngitis and often asymptomatic. Commonly seen in crowded or economically poor communities and having the history of this, and seen in school going children of age of 5 to 16 year of age, and more common in female. Acute rheumatic fever may cause heart disease during the acute phase. They call it rheumatic carditis. It may cause chronic valvular deformities and may manifest themselves year after a disease. Now there is a John's revised criteria for clinical diagnosis of rheumatic heart disease. The major criteria include the carditis, polyarthritis, chorea, subcutaneous nodules, and erythema marginatum. And the minor criteria include the fever, arthralgia, previous history of rheumatic fever, elevated ESRR, CRP and leukocytosis and prolonged PR interval. The morphology, this inflammation changes in the all the three layer of heart, that is a pancreatitis. And the hallmark of this rheumatic heart disease is multiple foci of inflammation in connective tissue of heart. And there's a ascope body is seen. This ascope body containing central focus of fibrinoid necrosis surrounded by lymphocytes, plasma cells and clump of macrophages called as anisocytes cells is a pathognomic for the rheumatic fever, which has abundant cytoplasm, central round to ovoid nuclei in which the chromatin is dispersed in a central slender wavy rhythm, hence called as a caterpillar cells. Also some of the larger macrophages become multinucleated to form ascope giant cells. Pericardial involvement in serofibrinous or pericarditis, with the serofibrinous or fibrinous pericarditis exuded, known as a bread and butter pericarditis, generally resolved without the serious cardiac defect. Microscopically, there is fibrin covered epicardium with the infiltration of polymorph, histocytes, plasma cells, and occasionally ascope body in pericardium or subendothelial tissue. Myocarditis, enlarged, soft, flabby heart with dilatation of all chambers and especially ventricles. Microscopically, rheumatic carditis is characterized by presence of scattered ascope body with interstitial connective tissue adjacent to intramyocardial blood vessel and non-specific interstitial myocarditis, and damage and destruction of myofibra leading to soft and dilated heart. And vegetation in endocardial environment, verruque seen along the line of closure is the classical feature of rheumatic heart disease. This is the vegetation seen along the line of closure of heart. This is a tiny 1 to 3 mm diameter, wart-like and extension firmly attached and lace-like to cause embolia. They arise from the vein at the site of erosion and related to underlying inflammation and collagen degeneration, causing later disturbance in cardiac function. Neural involvement seen in endocardium lining posterior wall of left atrium above the posterior leaflet of mitral wall due to regurgitation jet in front of irregular thickening of endocardium called as a Mac-Cullum plaque. Chronic rheumatic heart disease characterized by organization of acute inflammation and subsequent fibrosis. Irreversible deformity of one or more cardiac wall, mitral wall alone, involvement in 65 to 70% case, mitral plus aortic wall in about 25% case. Similar but less severe fibrous thickening and stenosis seen in tricuspid wall and rarely seen in pulmonary wall. Valve leaflet become thickened and retracted, causing permanent deformity. Cardinal changes of mitral wall are leaflet thickening, commissure fusion, shortening, thickening and fusion of tendinous cordae. In chronic disease, mitral wall is virtually always abnormal, almost in 99% of cases, but involvement of other wall like aortic are clinically more important in some cases. Microscopically, there is a diffuse fibrosis plus neurovascularization, ascope body replaced by fibrous scar. So this is acute inflammation. In acute case, there is a ascope bodies seen and its cells, and there is a pancarditis and vegetation on cordy tendine at the leaflet junction. Shown by this is the grossly, there is a shown by the arrow. In chronic, there is a thickened wall, commissure fusion, and thick, short cordy tendon seen on chronic rheumatic heart disease. This is a picture of Mac-Cullum plaques. This is a map-like area on the. This is the ascope body. Necrosis with composed of caterpillar cells. See, these are caterpillar cells. Chromatin is condensed in linear pattern. The mitral wall stenosis. See, the normal mitral walls in the picture of normal mitral wall and narrowing of the mitral wall is a calcified carotid stenosis due to rheumatic fever. It's indicated by the fusion and obliteration of commissures and note the irregular thickening of wall by calcific masses in the wall ring, protruding into the wall orifice and on outer surface, shown by the these three arrows. Thank you, and read the practical from your journal today. Thank you for listening.